3D bioprinting could spearhead personalized medicine. The prospect of printing human tissue has mesmerized both engineers and biologists. From a practical standpoint, 3D printing could aid in tissue production in a local doctor's office. One of the high-profile companies working in the 3D printing field is Cellink, which was founded 4 years ago by 31-year-old entrepreneur Erik Gatenholm. Cellink started as a developer of bio-ink for 3D bioprinters, a natural or synthetic polymer selected for its biocompatible components. Then, the firm built its own bioprinter that cost around $5,000. At the time, other 3D bioprinters cost over $300,000. Cellink noticed an untapped market in bio-ink 4 years ago. Gatenholm and two colleagues came across a material developed at Chalmers University of Technology in Sweden. According to Gatenholm, the material was the perfect culturing environment for cells. Eventually, they found a way to use it as a bioprinting filament. Gatenholm told SiliconRepublic.com about the early days of Cellink. At the time, persuading partner companies to come on board and purchase bio-ink was a major challenge despite there being a lot of interest in bioprinting. Printers were costly, Gatenholm noted. Not many laboratories across the globe are financially capable of funding those printers. Hence, Cellink decided to democratize the entire industry, creating a printer that cost $5,000. Presently, the company's bioprinting products are used by 1,800 laboratories worldwide. Many of them are working in basic applied research that could spearhead breakthroughs in the bioprinting industry. More recently, Cellink was included as part of a European research consortium called Triankle. Triankle's objective is to develop regenerative therapies in the form of 3D printed implants to regenerate ankle joint tissues. Further, bioprinting has become a tool in research to understand how COVID-19 affects the human body. 3D printing has proven to be very useful during the pandemic for the production of nasal swabs and other testing kits. However, bioprinting is more complicated. In fact, for Gatenholm, one area that bioprinting has become successful during the pandemic is in the printing parts of lung tissue. By growing basic versions similar to normal human lungs, researchers can understand how COVID-19 affects their function. Gatenholm sees the area of personalized medicine as a launching pad for his industry. For the founder, that's going to be for the future.